Hello and the greetings from Iceland. I'm going to use this short update to talk about my volcano tour since I am in Reykjavik now, doing daily trips to the Reykjanes Peninsula, flying up to the crater every day, and of course gathering shots like this that I can make into a longer video soon. And I've been playing around with the thermal drone as well, and I promise you a few goodies when I have time to edit them. But as usual, while I'm on the road, I have only limited time to do editing. And one of the reasons is that I want to fully process my footage first. And most importantly, I am as usual documenting the changes in the landscape, since the main question is still, what will Mother Earth send us next? While we have the smaller magma chamber still inflating and already at this critical point where we can expect just about anything. So it can be extremely dangerous to be around the crater now. And it's my drone that takes all the heat from this work now. And Icelandic experts seem to be expecting the ongoing eruption to throttle up soon and even become a fissure eruption like all the eruptions actually started. So we are stuck with this ongoing eruption with hardly any clue about how it will develop. So my thoughts are first and foremost about the town Grindavík now. How will this play out for them this time and in the long run? And to make the uncertainty even worse, lava can flow both ways from the crater now, but right now only flowing to the south. Like this is the southernmost part of the lava barrier, west of town, or how it looked 3 days ago, but today it looks a bit different. This little lava tongue just crawled over the barrier today, meaning that we have cheap material for the contractors or when they come to build the barrier higher up after the weekend. So this is not a big deal. And the reason for this is of course this big chunk of lava pushing this downhill from the crater. But to be realistic, if the eruption develops into a fissure eruption, stretching even further south, all we need is just a few hours on full blast and the lava will flow over parts of the town. And the tension grows by the hour now, since the magma chamber is full and we just don't know what to expect this time. However, it must be considered more likely that a new fissure will open up to the north from the crater or closer to the main source. And this next eruption, it will not be considered to be a new eruption. Just the same old that we are looking at now, just finding a new path to empty this magma chamber. It could be today or tomorrow, or we might have to wait for 2 weeks. So my plan is simple. I will be staying here for a few more days, but those missions far away from home are not simple. So I don't see myself waiting here for a few weeks before this next chapter starts. And while I'm not filming in Grindavík or by the Blue Lagoon, I've been using the days to drive around, fill up some gaps in my film stock and such. But as for the crater itself, I just love to film this thing. I just have to admit that. So I've been playing around with the drone up there. And I have this tendency to film long scenes. And many of those scenes, I can't do them justice in my updates. So I will be going back from this tour with huge amount of long and hot scenes. And some of them will end up with some music. And I was also shooting a lot of drone circles that will explain the surroundings better than I've been able to do so far. And the first one will be online very soon. So this has been a very good tour so far. And I will upload as much as I can when I find some time to do some editing here in Reykjavík. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.